Welcome to FactSpark. For as long as humans have settled the lowland savanna of today's Ghana, the white, black and red Volta rivers have been relentlessly flowing down from the Bobo-Dioulasso highlands of Burkina Faso to eventually end up in the Atlantic Ocean. The lower banks hosted communities of over 80,000 fishermen and farmers. But in 1960, a decision was made which would alter the region and the course of these rivers forever. After the construction of the giant Akosombo dam, within just 5 years, the savanna around the Volta River flooded to create the largest man-made reservoir in the entire world, spanning over 8,500 square kilometers, which is almost the size of Puerto Rico or Cyprus. The construction of the Akosombo dam, just 65 kilometers northeast of Ghana's capital Accra, stopped the natural flow of the river, which by this point has reached its maximum volumetric flow after combining all rivers in its drainage basin. The 114 meter tall, 660 meter long, and 366 meter wide structure retains the water of the river system for a total of 400 kilometers upstream, which led to permanent floodings of the area surrounding the river banks to create the gigantic reservoir. The Republic of Ghana gained its independence from the United Kingdom in 1960 and started the decade relatively stable. Cocoa was the main export of the young nation, and stable prices yielded economic prosperity, which President Kwame Nkrumah wanted to use to start a transformation to an agricultural industrial economy, instead of being entirely dependent on the export of cash crops. The first step was the utilization of vast bauxite deposits in Ghana's soil, which can be processed into aluminum, one of the most useful metals in nearly all industries. The only thing standing in the way between Ghana and a profitable aluminum industry, however, are the enormous electricity demands to run an aluminum smelter. This is where the Akosombo Dam comes into play, which has been proposed many decades before Ghana's independence, but got a resurgence with the concrete need for vast electricity supply. With high hopes of the new government, the work started quickly, and in 1966, after just 5 years of construction, the dam was finished and subsequently drowned an area behind it, the size of Rhode Island and Delaware combined. The hydroelectric power station in the dam provided around 900 megawatts of electricity, which easily allowed for the setup of an aluminum smelter and covered the entirety of the domestic electricity budget of Ghana at that time. It even left a surplus, which is being exported to neighboring Benin and Togo to build up foreign currency reserves. Looking at this project from the perspective of the American aluminum smelter operators, or the government which managed to achieve one of the highest levels of electricity access of any country in Africa, everything about the project seemed to have worked out. Like with every major infrastructure project, however, in reality the consequences are far more reaching than just the immediate economic output. Environmentally and socio-economically, the Akosombo Dam left a scar in rural Ghana, which will take a very long time to heal. The affected farmers and fishermen, which populated the riverbanks before its flooding, saw no direct benefits of the dam in the form of jobs or subsidies. The fishing and farming livelihood for many families has been destroyed, and the populations massively shrunk in size in the decades following, since the newly allocated land from the relocation couldn't support the needs of the people. Multiple entire ecosystems have been erased from the heart of Ghana and have been replaced with a disease-ridden reservoir, prone to eutrophication, and whose heat budget changes causes regional microclimate changes, such as decreasing rain and higher mean monthly temperatures, worsening the already harsh conditions. Whether the aluminum smelter and other industries which have spawned in the proximity of the newly created Lake Volta outweigh the hardship which have been brought upon the rural Ghanese population have been worth it, is a tough question to answer. In the past, examples of economic successes in this scale, without some kind of ecological or socio-economic compromise, have been very rare. Every dam, highway or reclamation area alters and destroys the existing nature to an almost irreversible extent. But without these feats of engineering, our modern lifestyle could not be achieved. The toll which Ghana took is giving up 3.6% of the landmass to a reservoir. A reservoir which, compared to the river which it previously was, does not regularly overflow and thus does not supply the new banks with sufficient nutrients for efficient agriculture. As a result, an increased usage of fertilizers is needed, which eventually ends up in the lake, which due to its stagnating water results in explosive growth of algae and weeds. This gives new habitats to mosquitoes, snails and flies, which bear illnesses such as snail fever, river blindness or malaria, which now ravage the area. or that the economic prosperity which resulted from access to electricity and the increase of its HDI to the fifth highest in continental Africa outside of the Arab world was worth this cost depends strongly on who you ask and will probably not be settled anytime soon. Thanks for watching. Subscribe and leave a like if you want to see more like it. Cheers.